Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Jacob, and today I want to share with you guys one thing that I recently discovered. So recently on my Patreon I was playing with Lab Color. Lab Color is this mode in Photoshop, and I created this video, why photo feels like a photo and render feels like a render. You can check it out on my Patreon. But now, as I was playing with Lab Color some more, I stumbled upon a super trippy effect. And that's pretty much how you can switch green trees or green plants into autumn plants with Lab Color with pretty much two clicks. And it works bizarrely well. Okay, so get this. If I go, and so I have like two images of just forest that I downloaded from the internet, right? So get this. If you go to image mode, Lab Color, right? And if you go to channels, you get lightness A and B. Lightness is pretty much the black and white info of the image. A is color from green to red, and B is from yellow to blue. Together, when you combine these two, you get a pure color information on the image. And of course, when you add lightness to that, you get your actual photo. Now get this strange thing. If you click on the A color, right? And if you invert it, so just press Control I, boom, you get instant autumn. So if you go to this one, image mode, Lab Color, and let me just enable all these, Control I, boom. Like, this looks, it's stupid how believable or how accurate these colors look like. It's like bang on autumn. And then I was thinking, this is an amazing and cool effect, but what can I do with it? And then one thing popped to my head. If I take, like, you know, plant objects, tree objects, and if I just take the leaf texture and do the same thing on the leaf, will I get the autumn texture, like autumn leaves, you know, autumn trees or whatnot? So get this. So I rendered these three images of just some close-ups of forests, etc. These lovely trees. Go away. Shoo. So these lovely trees, I'm just gonna take. Come on, dude. Go away. So these lovely trees, I'm just gonna take the leaf textures from them, and now I'm gonna just, you know, flip the A thing in Photoshop. So in my Photoshop, so the procedure is, you take an image, image mode, Lab Color, select A, inverted by Control I, and just revert image back to RGB. That's it, right? For this one, also the same procedure, just invert it, revert back to RGB. For this one, for example, since it already has some brown momentums, you know, it has like these autumn-y kind of textures. For this one, I don't want to flip these also because they're just going to look weird. Look, if I go to Lab Color here and just flip those, they're just going to turn green, right? So the plan is, I'm just going to select, I don't know, these, and I'm going to select these and just go to color A and just invert that, and boom, I got these. Now I'm going to save these. I'm just going to add the underscore one and just save it just so that I easily know how these are called. And now in my Macs, I'm going to be using Project Manager, where I'll just quickly kind of reload those textures. So here you can see, this is the one. I'm just going to press F2 to rename and put underscore one. This one, underscore one, it will automatically, as you can see, reload in my scene. This one, underscore one. By the way, nothing is sponsored in this video, so don't, you know. Underscore one, and let's go to this one. Actually, before I do this one, let me just check how this whole thing looks like so far. So if I click my render, look at this. Look at the colors in the back. Look at this thing. And now let me just finish the whole thing. So this one, underscore one, and now this one. Okay, that's how I've replaced all of them. Let me just move my Max to the left and just put my Photoshop here as a, you know, some sort of reference. Look at this. That looks stupid. Look at this. You like instantly get all these autumn-y colors, and it's just by, you know, flicking that one layer thing. You know, I was trying to see online if there is any tutorial that maybe, you know, covers it in this way. I wasn't able to find one, which doesn't mean that I'm the creator of the whole thing, right? I wasn't able to find any. But, you know, all these kind of sources that I've seen, it's all, you know, like color correcting, tweaking, turning hues, etc. This is just, you know, Lab Color, color A, invert, throwback to RGB, and that's done. You can actually put that as an action, so it's like a one-click solution to just convert it. But yeah, look at this. This looks freaking fantastic. Look, you got all the like vibrant colors and everything. Yeah. Anyhow, feel free to kind of readjust this if needed. I literally just inverted it. I didn't do any additional tweaks or anything. But yeah, I thought it was a cool thing to share. So hope this saves someone's ass this autumn in all the deadlines and stuff. Catch you later. Bye.